Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. So today I just wanted to take y'all with me just to show y'all a typical day of what I go through and things that I have to do as a nurse on the night shift rotation at a nursing home. So when we come into work, we have to get our temperatures checked, and I believe if it's anything above 100 degrees, then we would have to get it rechecked, and then after that, I mean, I'm pretty sure we're going to be good because we haven't had anybody that has had a temperature that actually come to work. I mean, if you come into work and you have a temperature, you would know and you shouldn't even come to work. So now I'm just stocking my cart, just making sure that I have everything that I will need throughout the night, like gloves, condom catheters, some, you know, skilled things that I will need. I love this fish tank when it's lit up at night. So as I'm placing everything on my cart that I'm going to need during my first round, I'm just basically trying to organize everything. I do not like crap all over my freaking cart. I don't know, it just makes me go crazy. But I start to place everything inside the cart that it needs to be inside, things that I'm going to need when I get to the patient's room, I put at the top, and that's it. And I'm just pretty much just organizing everything. Now this here is a report paper that I made for myself. I also placed some copies at the nurse's station just for anybody that came across it and wanted to use it. But personally, I've never seen a nurse at a nursing home use a report sheet like this. I don't know. I think maybe because all the patients are, like, you have the same patients at the nursing home, so you pretty much know. But I personally use this for, like, anything new, anything that I need to, anything that's important, you know, anything critical. So I just put the patient's numbers on here, and then how I, because we have so many patients, how I split it up is I put like how I'm doing for the bed four. Above the line will be A bed, and then below the line will be B bed. And I do that for all of them, especially when I'm doing my temperatures, you know, during COVID, we have to do that. And then so the columns that I have here are notes, anything important for the labs, like if they have critical labs. The next one, diet or allergies, any diet or allergy changes for a patient. Any vitals, like their temperature or any blood pressures, the doctor, and then their code status. If they're a full code or if they're hospice or if they are a DNR. Now, after I get everything organized and I get my paper and I go down my hall and do my temperatures, I start to do some checkoffs. So basically, these are just some 24-hour, I'm sorry, not 24 hours, some the shift checkoffs. So basically, any patient that's on any antidepressants, we have to monitor for any type of reactions, any type of signs and symptoms, you know. We have to just check off things, to if they're on oxygen, if they have the pain. We have to do all that. And the system that we use is point-click care. Now this here, so you can always, like for here, their pain scale, you can always go back to see what the other nurse documented, like what was their previous pain scale, or like for their oxygen, what was their previous oxygen. You can also do that. So yeah, when we do that, you put in their oxygen, you put the number, and then if they have a trach, if they are on room air, if they're on nasal cannula, you place that there. And we only do that once when we're coming on the shift.
It's not for me to say you love.
So I'm just going to the passport to pull my night meds. Now at night we have midnight medication. Well, not every patient, but some patients have midnight medications and then the morning run, which is pretty much the thyroids, because you have to give that medication on an empty stomach. Now, if you have a patient that has a G-tube, this is some of the supplies that you will need for them. That blue bag is for the water, and then that formula, that's their food. Not every patient has that same formula, but that's the formula that they will have. Now, this is called the kangaroo pump. Once you undo the bag, you will see, but you will pull it down. And you see that flat part is sticking out, and then you'll pull it up. It'll stretch it, so you put it up, and then you'll close it. And then you press the power button, and it comes on. Most of the time, it's already set. If the patient has been on it and you didn't start it, then it's already set. And you will prime it, and you'll do auto prime. So here I'm just charting. I'm doing my skin assessment charting. So usually I chart that like towards the end of the shift, but because we were short a nurse and I was one of the nurses that had to split, I had to chart early because I didn't want to be behind. So with point click care, this is what we use. You will go to assessments and then this square will pop up, and then you will go to weekly treatments and then the type of assessment. For me, I put other because I do nights. So if they have any skin problems in this section where it says site, you will follow the numbers on the body and then you will place it. And then you just answer in the questions there, and then in the additional comments. Not every place uses different words or different statements, but this is what I put. No skin issues noted during shift, or no skin tears noted during shift, or skin intact. You know. Simple. It's not for me to say you love me. It's not for me to say. Hey baby, it's 5 o'clock. It's time to run everything up, clean up my cart, because baby, I'm ready to go. Today is actually now Saturday, but it is considered my Friday. This is my weekend off, and y'all know how I love my weekends off. I don't play no games. I love my weekends off. So yeah, I'm just pretty much just cleaning up my cart, and then I do wipe down all my supplies with bleach also. And then also at the end of the shift, we do the glucose checks just to make sure that they are functioning properly. So I done finally made it home after this long, long, long night. As I said, I had to split. Well, me and another nurse had to split another hall. And now, if you work in a nursing home, you know that's crazy. Like, I had 21 patients, she had 26 patients, and then we had to split a hall that had 26 patients also. So you do the math. So yeah, I'm just having this rice cake and a banana and my tea just to put a little something on my stomach, because this morning I'm supposed to be going to the fit camp. That's supposed to be at 9:30. So after I eat this, and while I wait to go to fit camp, I am going to go through my microbiology. As y'all know, I am taking this course over for my prerequisite for the transition program. So once I'm done with this, it should be time for me to go, hopefully, because I don't want to just be sitting here not doing nothing. Last time that happened, I fell asleep. Thank y'all so much for watching my video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see y'all in the next one. Bye.